WZR Radio starts now. You can join us in the live chat room at WZROnline.com/chat. Or call into the show at 518-712-3070. I'm coming up for air so I can check myself again and I stand. Ruined to the man but sheltered. Confidence retained. Now, here are your hosts, Matt Boone and Ryan Clark.
How's it going, everybody, and welcome to the Tuesday, February 2nd, 2010 edition of WZR Radio here on WZROnline.com. I'm, as always, your host, Ryan Clark. Got Matt Boone back.
Oh, yeah!
Back and better than ever, David Alice. How are we feeling this week, my man?
I'm feeling much better. Thank you for asking.
That's a good thing, man. We had to end a little bit early last week. We didn't have a lot to talk about last week, anyway.
Well, we got most of it out of the way before Mike.
Before your unbelievable.
Before I just could not continue. Yes, I was out. Yeah, I was not ready for that.
Yeah, you were a little bit out there last week, under the weather, and we're back.
I didn't get any better the next day, by the way. That shit continued almost to the weekend.
Ouch!
It wasn't fun. Yeah.
No good. No good. But we got a lot to talk about tonight, man. We're gonna be here for 2 hours tonight. We got we had the Royal Rumble pay per view on Sunday night and Monday Night Raw last night. Bret Hart, Big Mark, Bret Hart.
I got plenty to say. I haven't talked to you about that yet either, so I'm interested to see what you thought. Because I'll just tell you right out of the gate, I thought it sucked, and I love Bret Hart. So
it was just set up to the WrestleMania angle because I think they're gonna do. We've got major WrestleMania spoilers.
Is one of them Bret and Vince, or are they talking about a tag with Batista and somebody?
Well, the deal is it's going to be a tag match. It's supposed to be Batista and Vince on one side, and then Cena and Bret on the other side. They could do that because the original plans called for. We're gonna talk about this a lot more in depth later on. But the original plans called for one-on-one matches at WrestleMania. Well, you do. I mean, obviously Bret can't work a match, and Vince can't work a match.
So it'd be like a street fight.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah, I mean, you've got a pay-per-view in between now and WrestleMania, so you could do the tag match at the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view and then go from there and build up the one-on-one matches at WrestleMania, which was the original plan. You know what I mean? So I don't know. And then, I mean, that's a way to... I think the Elimination Chamber match or matches themselves sell the pay-per-view as it is, but I mean to put Bret Hart, you know, in a ring on the pay-per-view, I mean, I think that would draw as well. You know, build up a tag team match on that pay-per-view, and then do the singles matches at WrestleMania. So
I think the tag team thing. I don't know. I don't like it. I don't see why they can't just do Bret and Vince in the street. We'll talk about it later. But we had Strike Force this past Saturday. We're gonna get to that, right? Bobby Lashley and all that stuff. That was pretty good. UFC 109 this Saturday with Randy Couture fighting Mark Coleman. So I have to talk about Frank Trigg on that card. He's been in TNA before. You know him. A lot of good names, actually. That's their big Super Bowl weekend card. We got the Super
Trigg
Bowl
on that card?
Weekend.
Trigg's on
Trigg versus Sarah, Matt Sarah.
No shit, wow.
Yeah, that's a good one. Wow. Every fight, look, I'll just, Randy Couture versus Mark Coleman, Nate Marquardt versus Chael Sonnen, Dan Miller versus Damian Maia, Frank Trigg versus Matt Sarah, and then Mike Swick versus Paulo Thiago. So every fight's a good one.
Yeah, we'll talk about that. MMA, Strikeforce, UFC, like Boone just said, Strikeforce from Saturday night. Bobby Lashley was on there. Robbie Lawler, Diaz was on. Herschel Walker, all those guys. So we're gonna talk about that card as well. And UFC 109, like Boone said, coming up this Saturday night. And big WrestleMania spoilers. You guys, you've heard some of the stuff on the websites, and I've got a bunch more for you tonight where, they're talking about a match, and obviously we're going to run this down later, but they're talking about a match because it was originally supposed to do, they were going to do Randy Orton versus Ted DiBiase in a singles match at WrestleMania, and now the talk is, and I got this confirmed by someone today, well, not confirmed, but it's in the in the early plans, you know what I mean, for WrestleMania, and they did the angle at the Royal Rumble to set this up. Basically, I've heard that there's going to be a triple threat match at WrestleMania, and it's going to feature all three Legacy members, and then you'd have their fathers, which would be in each corner. So you'd have Dusty Rhodes, Cody Rhodes, you'd have Ted DiBiase Sr., Ted DiBiase Jr., and you'd have Bob Orton for Randy Orton. So that is a big new scoop that I haven't put up on the website, and got some more WrestleMania spoilers. Jericho's opponent for the WrestleMania pay-per-view as well. So we'll save that here. I don't know, at some point during hour number two. We've got a lot to talk about here in hour number one with Royal Rumble and Raw from last
night. You're going to talk about the tapings tonight. What we got going on there?
We got, is that right? It's in St. Louis?
That's what I got. Yeah, I think so.
All right, they were in Nashville last night, so Missouri seems kind of, I don't know. St. Louis, Missouri, SmackDown and ECW tapings tonight. Hopefully we'll have some spoilers before we go off the air. They just announced on WWE.com that Vince McMahon is going to appear on tonight's show and basically discuss the future or the fate of ECW and some big change. I know you don't follow ECW on a weekly basis
at all.
There's some big changes in stuff.
I heard they're rebranding it. Yeah, so
without the letters.
Oh yeah, they're gonna rename it too.
That's what I've heard, man. Oh. I mean, yeah.
We got any names? Any guesses or what?
I don't know. Sci-Fi. They had meetings with Sci-Fi several months ago, and I guess Sci-Fi, and they've always been like this. Sci-Fi is like a they've got monsters and stuff like that. Science fiction stuff.
Yeah.
Stuff, exactly. And I don't know. So they want to incorporate things into that show and basically
they did that a while in the beginning of ECW when ECW first came back. They would have like a monster come out or some crap. Well, they did something like that, I remember, because of
was it the Boogeyman? They had the Boogeyman.
Maybe that was it. There was some, I could have sworn it was like a character from one of, I don't know, whatever. But either way, yeah. So, I don't know. Maybe I'll have to check out the first new, not ECW, but whatever the hell Sci-Fi show is going to be and see what they do with it. Is it going to be their C brand still, or is it going to be like, is it going to get upgraded in talent, or?
No, it's actually a downgrade.
Oh, a developmental thing?
Like an FCW thing. Where
on TV?
Yeah, on TV. I mean, that's the plan, and then they were going to drop the letters to ECW as well. So, I don't know. I mean, you may see something, I want to say similar to what they did on TNA Impact on the Monday Night Special, where basically the guys in charge, Eric Bischoff and Hogan, came out and said, you know what, we're going to shake things up, the hell with this, we're getting rid of this, we're getting rid of that, it's our new rules, and I could see Vince doing something like that tonight where he comes out and basically trashes ECW, says this show sucks, and we're going to rebrand it. And
oh, he's going to be on ECW. I can't even believe I didn't put that together. When you said tonight, I assume you meant the taping for SmackDown. So he's going to be live or on ECW that airs tonight.
Right.
Shit.
Tonight's ECW, yeah. He's going to make a big announcement on the future of ECW. So we'll see what happens with that. Hopefully, like I said, we'll have some spoilers for you guys here in just a little bit, probably at some point in our number two. We'll get to that. Also, at the SmackDown tapings tonight, we've got, basically, I put this on the website last night. Every year, you have two Elimination Chamber matches. You have one for Raw, which we did the qualifying matches last night. Raw was actually fairly good last night.
I watched the whole thing. I was only watching for Brett, and like a million times I wanted to mute it and turn music on, but like something would happen where I would stay enough interested. Like, I wasn't giddy over the show, but there was enough stuff going on that I was, like, you know, interested about that I kept it on. Yeah, I watched the whole thing, and I didn't hate it.
Well, it was good wrestling, man. I mean,
all the matches were, like, big names and, like, you know, good combos. Like, I remember when Swagger came out, he was in the ring, and Jerry Lawler was talking about he likes his chances, and no matter who his opponent is tonight, and then, boom, the game hits.
Yeah.
It was pretty cool. So, yeah, but, yeah, everybody.
Yeah, and we had Orton versus Shawn Michaels, too.
Yeah, didn't see that. Yeah, a lot of good ones.
So we'll run down.
Weird angle too with Big Show. That was the weirdest thing. I don't know what the hell that was even about. But
well, the ending where, I mean, everybody wanted Cena, and I guess it's gonna play out over which is good. You know what I mean? Where
the ending is confusing because I didn't even understand what the hell was going. I mean, I know they're setting up an angle, But like it was just weird. Like they continued the same thing they did on the 4th of January, where, you know, they talked about the screw job, blah 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 blah. Then they started slowly incorporating the kick to the gut, which I could have sworn was a nut job kick, but I guess we're gonna go.
Well,
with gut.
No. Brett said it was too, in an interview where basically he said he got kicked in the balls. It was supposed to be much, kicked him in the balls, and Brett felt that you know, that made the angle come off better. But last night, obviously, they referenced the, what are they going to say, I kicked you in the balls? You know what I mean? So, I don't know. I mean,
I don't know what they were like. Next thing you know, Batista's out there, and I'm sitting there like, wait a minute.
He's
not on Raw, so how are they going to, you know, do that without moving him?
The week before, they had Cena out there with the promo with Vince.
Yeah, I didn't watch. That's why.
That's where things go.
Oh, no, the Cena, I saw that, where he said that Vince has to be a man or something and bring, and then, I saw that, but have to do with anything? Where the hell did he come from? He just comes out and helps Vince?
Because they're going to set up the Cena versus the man, you know, that's just storylines, but it's not, I mean, it's basically, last night they planted the seeds, the very early seeds for a storyline, and that's probably why it doesn't make much sense. But of course, next week you'll have Cena come out, and then you get the retaliation, or maybe even Cena's over at the SmackDown tapings tonight, goes out there and confronts Batista or something like that, you know what I mean? And then next week on Monday Night Raw, we'll set up the tag match, and whether that happens at Elimination Chamber, you know, I bet that it happens at Elimination Chamber, and then they do the one-on-one matches, because don't you think, I mean, you could do a tag team match between all four of those guys at WrestleMania, or you could do one-on-one matches, and when you break it down, one-on-one matches, bro, I mean, if you have Cena and Batista, I mean, that's a mega match right there, and then Vince versus Brett, you know?
You got to look at it from this way. You want to put Brett's first time doing any kind of in-ring anything on an Elimination Chamber pay-per-view instead of WrestleMania? You got to have him do the first.
You do it in a tag match, which would be at...
Yeah, but he's still going to be in the ring, and you don't want to see anything with him in the ring until WrestleMania.
That's true, but you still have to...
You got to save it there. You got to save that. You saw him throw some crappy punches there. He looked bad, too, by the way. We'll talk about it. But
I know.
Yeah, he threw some punches. He didn't do anything. He didn't hit the ropes. He didn't do any moves. Like, he started the sharpshooter. He didn't do it. You don't want to see none of that until you're, you know, paying for it like you're supposed to. That's business.
That's true. I don't know. I mean, they could do... We'll talk about it. We'll talk about it in Monday Night Raw. Let's get these plugs out of the way. SmackDown, ECW tonight. We talked about Elimination Chamber. They set up... They had qualifying matches last night on Monday Night Raw, which we'll talk about here in just a minute. I expect the same thing at SmackDown tonight. You've only got a few weeks to go until the Elimination Chamber, so you've got to get that out of the way. You know what I mean? So I'd expect... SmackDown Elimination Chamber qualifying matches tonight at the SmackDown taping, similar to what they did on Raw. And then they announced on Raw last night that the Cutting Edge is going to return with special guest The Undertaker. I'm a big fan of Edge. You are too.
Me too, man. I remember when he first started becoming like the breakout star he became, when he first started that, the Rated R and all that stuff.
Right.
He would tell me, like, yo, Edge has got it going on, man. He's good. And I would watch it. I was like, what are you doing? Dude, he's trash. What the hell are you talking? You were right on that one, man. He's good.
He's a great heel. I still don't have you sold on Miz yet. But
I'm warming up. I got to be honest. When he cut that promo with the pants on the ground stuff at the Rumble, I was like, Miz, you're the man, bro. You are awesome. That was cool as shit.
How about that pants on the ground? You guys know. Listen, you guys know that my boy Matt Boone had no idea what the fuck pants on the ground.
I don't watch American Idol. I got a penis, dude. What the hell am I going to watch karaoke competition
for? Listen, I told you. Listen, I don't watch American Idol either. But when they do the auditions, where people come in there and they go from city to city, that's good stuff, man, because that's entertaining TV, you know? And you can
but I don't watch TV really either, so I don't. I never know what's going on in pop culture. Like, I remember the Haiti earthquake. I didn't know about
Stern.
That's exactly. I get every single thing about anything from Stern. Like, I didn't even know Jay Leno was on Oprah until Monday when Howard talked about it and came back from the weekend, you know, all that stuff. And, like, Haiti's earthquake, I didn't know about that until Bubba the Love Sponge said, fuck Haiti. Like, I'm completely out of the loop, man. So, yeah, I'm not going to get no pants on the ground thing going on.
Pants on the ground, pants on the ground. Looking like a fool with your pants.
With your pants on the ground. Oh, yeah.
I turn sideways.
Talking out the side of your mouth with your pants on the ground. Pants on the ground.
General, you know what his name is? It's they call him General Larry Platt.
Larry Platt. Why, I don't know why that sounds familiar.
Pratt or Platt?
Platt. P-L-A-T-T, right?
No, I think it's P-R-A-T-T.
P-R? All right. Because I know the name Platt, so I don't know Pratt.
Yeah. Whatever.
Fuck that.
Pants on the ground. Looking like a fool with your pants on the ground. All right. So the dark match is Undertaker versus Batista at the SmackDown tapings. And yeah, that's what we got going on. Hopefully we'll have live SmackDown spoilers. Jesus, man, live radio. It's going to be all over YouTube. Pants on the ground, pants on... We'll have our rendition all over YouTube.
Yeah, because we got that guy who puts our stuff on YouTube now. That's right.
Well, I came on here, God, back in the gray days, and I had, what was the song?
You did Yellow Submarine, and he put that on YouTube.
Yeah, dude, and if you go and you search for YouTube, and you do a search for, like, Ryan Clark wrestling or something like that, that's the first thing that pops up.
It's got your picture on it, too, there, huh?
I know. It's got the sexy beast on that, huh?
Yep. I get it.
Yeah, you get it.
I'm choking on it, so I'm tired of it. Yeah, I couldn't keep it together, man.
Yeah. Hey, let me, let's get some chat shout-outs out of the way. WZROnline.com/chat. Once again, WZROnline.com/chat. We've got a lot of people. I don't know.
I forgot to go in there. I'm going in now.
A lot of Boone names in there tonight. Boone.
See, it says the stream's off air still for me. I guess we're on the air though, right?
Yeah, I think you got to refresh the chat page if you were stuck on it. I edited that earlier. Yeah, we're live.
Okay, cool.
WZROnline.com/chat. WZROnline.com/chat. Get the live chat room now. There's
I know what it is. Did you edit the PWS version of the chat with the new stream?
I believe so, yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, that's just weird then. All right, cool.
Well, maybe not. I don't know what I did. Whatever. We were running late. Actually, you know what? I think that's going to be a problem on a weekly basis because, shoot. You know what? I was so pissed. I got to tell this.
I don't care. Shoot.
I was so fucking mad at you before we went live at about 6 o'clock when we were trying to put the stream up. And I'm saying to myself, dude, it's the same thing we did last week. And I know you were...
I was out of it last week, yes.
Right, but I'm thinking it's the same thing we do every week. It's really
but
not.
It didn't turn out to be the same thing, remember?
No, I know.
You had to change the code and all that? Yeah, I couldn't find it. What do you need to do?
Well, I think that's going to be a weekly thing. I think we're going to have to change the code, every time
we're
live.
That would be a pain in the ass.
No, it is a pain.
Well, if we do, you got to show me where you get the code, because I still don't, to this second, know where it's at. I have no clue.
Well, I do it in the live post, and then I updated it on the chat room thing, but, God, I don't know, man. Hopefully it's
Should we, you got a poll I should put up right now at the beginning so they can get
posted? Right, we can poll. I
forgot.
All right, well, let's do a, I don't know. What do you want to do for Paul? Monday Night Raw? A, B, C, D?
We've only got four spaces, so it'd have to be up to D.
That's right. We'll do a, I don't know, shit, man. Make a poll, dude. I don't know. Well, let's, I guess we got to talk about Royal Rumble first, but let's,
I'll do the grade for the Rumble. What grade would you do for the Rumble?
A, B, C, or D, without the
Yep, D is the worst you can get.
All right, no doubt. I thought, overall, Royal Rumble, I hated the Rumble.
The match.
The problem is usually in Rumbles you get. I like it when there's like 10 or 15 guys in there, or 20 guys in there at once, and you didn't have that during this Rumble. I mean, at one time maybe there was, I don't know, eight.
Yeah, about eight.
Guys
I was gonna
in there.
Say, yeah.
You know, it just didn't. I don't know. It didn't seem like a Rumble where, and then you didn't have your spots where Kane came in and eliminated. I mean, I know you don't want to see that every year, same Rumble every year.
I know.
Something wasn't there for me during the
I like the CM Punk stuff. I thought that
CM
was awesome.
CM Punk stuff was cool. That was really good.
Like, I don't watch SmackDown, so I haven't seen his new character with the Save Me and all that crap, but
right.
I think his whole new gimmick is awesome. I like it.
It is, man, and he's done that on house shows as well. They're taking that gimmick to house shows.
Yeah, he saves somebody out of the audience every week, right?
Well, yeah.
It's usually like a local wrestler or something. Yeah, that's the only reason I think he was even...
saves them and also shaves them, too. They do the angle where he, you know, comes in and shaves their head.
I didn't know that.
At house shows as well, they're doing that. I don't know. Trying to... get up my, here it is, my Royal Rumble report. Let's run it down from top to bottom. We're going to fly through this because I want to get through Royal Rumble and Monday Night Raw in hour number one. And then hour number two, we got, like I said at the beginning of the show, we've got big WrestleMania 26 spoilers, current plans. Obviously, those can change. But, yeah, we've got big big spoilers here in hour number two. We're going to take live phone calls as well. Live chat room, WZRonline.com/chat. A lot of good stuff planned. Chat shout-outs as well in hour number two. So, Royal Rumble, I mean, overall great.
We've also got Strikeforce and UFC, goddammit. Overall great, I would give it a... the whole pay-per-view? Yeah, I didn't like pretty much anything up until the Rumble.
Is that right? Really?
At least off the top of my head. Maybe when we get into it, I'll remember something I liked. But I would say C+.
C+. Do we have a... What's the poll? What did you put up?
Poll right now is B's winning. Oh, wait, now they're going crazy, so I don't know. Yeah, B and A seems to be the consensus. B and A.
Is the poll supposed to pop up, or...?
It's up there. We've got what? 12. We got 16 votes already. It's going crazy now. They're voting all over it.
Guys that are listening live, vote in the poll. I can't get this thing to load. I'm having problems here. But it's over in the on the media player that you're listening live, where you hit the play button. It's over on the bottom left hand corner. You see a little thing that says poll, and you can vote on the poll. We'll have taken. What is it? Royal Rumble. Your thoughts on the Royal Rumble? A, B, C, or D? We don't have an F option, so A, B, C, or D, what do you guys think? And after we're done with the Royal Rumble, we'll read the full results off here on the live show.
We must got a lot of people listening. Jesus Christ, they're voting. Wow.
Yeah, tons of people, man. We kicked the Royal Rumble off with ECW title match, Christian versus Ezekiel Jackson for the ECW title.
I didn't see this one.
No, they're building up.
Well, they had the problem with DirecTV, remember?
Right.
Yeah, we didn't get to see. We turned on like for the last maybe 5 minutes of the match, I believe.
Yeah, we, and that wasn't a thing with, by the way, guys, we watched the Royal Rumble at WrestlingStreams.net. Rob's a good guy over there. You can, I think you only pay like $6 a month or something, and you get UFC, TNA, and WWE, all the pay-per-views, and they never skip, and if you got $6, I think you can PayPal or however you want to do it, but you get three pay-per-views. I mean, $6, when you're paying $30, $40 for a pay-per-view, and you're paying $6 and you get all three of them. WrestlingStreams.net, go over there and sign up. That's a nice plug for him, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was a good one, though. That was a good one. Yeah.
But WrestlingStreams.net, thanks to Rob for hooking us up. But like Boone said, they had DirecTV problems, and it came back, I believe, at the end where Christian went for the kill switch and got the pin. I heard it was good. But I mean,
I have no idea.
Back at the very end, actually, I sent you a message and said Christian just retained the ECW title, and that's when you popped it back on. So I mean, basically, I just came back on and hit the kill switch engage for the.
Yeah, I thought they were giving the belt to Big Zeke in that one. I guess they went against it for some reason.
Yeah, I did too, because they have been pushing.
Maybe they're waiting for the new ECW before they switch the title or something. I don't know.
That's true.
Because he would only be ECW champion for like a week, and then they're not going to be no such thing as an ECW champion anymore, you know?
Well, yeah, and then you've got the draft coming up, too. So guys like Christian may finally get their chance to step off.
Well, that was my other question. If they're changing ECW to like a developmental thing, Christian and those guys, are they still going to be mixed in with the developmental stuff? Like other, not even just Christian, but like anybody, Matt Hardy, any of those guys, are they going to be mixed in? Or are they just going to have them all go to Raw and SmackDown and then ECW will be strictly developmental guys?
Yeah, it'll be interesting, man, to see what they... I mean, I've heard that it's going to be basically all up-and-comers, you know what I mean? Guys out of FCW that are just about ready, and then give them a place to shine on ECW, which will be under a new name. But, I mean, you would think that they'd keep some of the veteran talent there, if you will. The guys like William Regal and Christian and... I don't know who else is over there on ECW.
Matt Hardy.
Guys like that. No, Matt Hardy's on SmackDown. But I mean, some of the veteran guys, to have them come over and basically stay there and give some of these guys the rub, unless you're just going to make it all developmental and have guys like Zack Ryder against Tyler Rex or somebody. I don't know. I mean, ECW, I mean, Spotify is not happy with that 1.0 rating as it is right now, and I'm thinking if you take guys like Christian and Regal and your veteran guys off that show, I mean, that's not gonna do anything to...
Well, you got to see what they do tonight, what Vince says tonight and how they do it, because you never know. It could be like a cool angle or something that would draw interest, you know, so the names don't need to, you know what I mean?
Right. And it'll be...
You never know what they're doing.
Well, it'll be interesting to see if... Everybody always wonders if Vince McMahon is a draw or not, you know, and that was a last minute decision.
He draws me, I'll tell you that. He always draws me. If you say Vince is on my TV right now, I'm turning it on, because I'll say, hold on, Ryan, I can't do the show for like 5 minutes. Let me hear this promo.
But you know that was a last minute change, because obviously if they had plans in place...
They would have mentioned it last night, yeah.
Oh, obviously.
Yeah.
Because
Vince on ECW, absolutely, yeah.
Right, so I'm thinking something changed earlier today, you know, when they did the scripting earlier, and that, because they were plugged that. I mean, they'd obviously plug a Vince McMahon appearance on ECW. So it'd be interesting to see. Everybody always wonders, is Vince McMahon a draw? So we'll see what we'll see if ECW draws that 1.0 rating, and we'll see if it's bumped up when it comes out at some point, probably tomorrow. By the way, Raw did a 3.6 rating, which I believe is even with the past 2 weeks.
I don't remember, man. I do not remember.
Yeah, I believe so. All right, back to the Royal Rumble. We had a backstage segment. It was Teddy Long and Tiffany. Crime Time showed up, and basically there's a disagreement here. Crime Time, only one of the guys is allowed in the Royal Rumble tonight, and that brings in the Great Khali.
Well, they both want to be in. That's why they're bitching, yeah.
Well, yeah, and then Great Khali comes in, and Miz came in, and they did the,
Well, what they did was, they said Great Khali is willing to give them their spot if he can kiss Tiffany. That was the angle.
Okay, all right. Yeah. And then, I mean, Khali came in, and the next thing you know, he's doing the Steve Urkel thing with the, did I do that?
Did he? Oh, I remember. I think I remember that.
Khali says, he said...
I remember who let the dogs out.
And who let the dogs out too? He did that, and then he pulled up the pants or something and did the Steve Urkel thing. Did I do that? And I don't know. Miz came in at some point here, and it was like a whole Family Matters, right?
Yeah, well, he came in and he said something like, he's like, guys, do you realize in 5 years when people watch this show that you're not going to know what the hell you're talking about with this pants on the ground stuff? And I thought that was awesome.
Right.
Pardon the pun, yeah.
Teddy got pissed off here and, got pissed at the Miz and basically told him that he's got a match for the United States title, going to defend the title next against MVP. So that was an impromptu match at the Royal Rumble pay-per-view. We had a backstage segment. Cody Rhodes was back there with Randy Orton, basically ratted out Ted DiBiase. He said, I don't know, man, I haven't talked to Ted in weeks, da-da-da-da-da. And then later on in the show, we had Ted basically said, I don't know what's up with Cody, blah, 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 blah. So basically, that's where they started the angle where...
Yeah. Well, they've been off and on, and that was the whole point of him coming up, was he was apologizing because he says, you know, he may have been like, not, you know, because the last few weeks they've been like almost threatening him, like, if you don't win your match, we're going to whip your ass, you're out of legacy. So he says he just wants to let you know, I've got your back, but I can't say the same for Ted DiBiase. Like you said, he ratted him out, and then Ted did the same thing later.
Exactly, and that's, I mean, basically, that was the, I know they've been teasing a legacy breakup for weeks here, but basically that was the start of the storyline. Like I said earlier, when we get to WrestleMania 26 spoilers coming up later, but basically the plan is to do a triple threat match with all three of their fathers in the corner of each man. So we'll see if that pans out or not, but the original plan was to do Ted DiBiase Jr. versus Randy Orton in a one-on-one contest. So this continues the legacy breakup. So next up we had Miz versus MVP for the U.S. title. This was decent. But you know what? I'm not going to run down each match. Yeah, I mean, we'll talk about the big things. Because I want to squeeze in Strikeforce or UFC before we go off the air here. Well, not off the air, but before we go to the hourly break. Yeah, so we'll squeeze that in. Miz versus MVP, I mean, this is good. Both of these guys have shown improvements in recent years, obviously. MVP is,
he's good, over, right? But they're not, I mean, he's over. Like, the crowd digs him. He's doing what he's supposed to be doing. But, I mean, they were starting to warm up to him and give him, like, a little push there. And then they just took it completely away from him. I don't know what happened, but, like, he was looking like one of the next big deals. Now they started doing it with Kofi Kingston. He's back down doing nothing. I don't know what.
Well, I don't know know about Kofi. They put Kofi in the Elimination Chamber match last night. So
yeah, but look how he got in.
Yeah, by disqualification. Right?
Yeah, but Big Show had to punch a referee in the face for him to get in.
Right, that's true. That's true. And you know he's not going to win, obviously.
Absolutely not. No.
Yeah, but still the fact that he's in there, so they still consider him one of the top guys.
I think what they're doing is the beginning of his descend instead of his beginning of his... like, for a while, it was the start of his ascending, you know, up
right.
the ladder. You could see him with Orton, like, getting bigger, and he's going to become a big deal, and now they're slowly bringing him down, it seems like. Like, they're not going to do it in one day, so, but, like, it seems like they're starting to slowly, you know, drop him down the level a little bit, which I don't understand why, because he's over like a son of a bitch if you listen to the crowd.
Yeah. Yeah, we had Chris Jericho on the Big Show, had a talk backstage. Jericho sporting a black right eye. We've got to talk about that, too, huh?
Yeah, I got that in there.
Yeah, we didn't talk about that last week, but Jericho has black right eye. Wonder where that came from, huh?
Holy crap. I don't even know the whole thing with that story. I heard bits and pieces, so I know enough, but, yeah.
You hear what happened today with the Soma thing?
Soma's, yeah, yeah.
Oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. So they had a talk backstage, and basically, what was it? R-Truth.
Basically, Chris Jericho was telling Big Show how Miz is just using him, and that Chris Jericho and Big Show were the better tag team. Big Show said Miz is better, and then I guess Chris Jericho was... I don't remember what the R-Truth thing. I remember that Chris Jericho went to talk about Big Show having his back and turned around.
R-Truth came up to Jericho backstage and basically said, "That's the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Blah, blah. I'm going to throw you out of the Royal Rumble tonight. That's the whole truth."
Yeah, and he said you got to get through Big Show first. Turns around and Big Show's not there anymore. So
exactly. Then we had Randy Orton pissed off backstage. DiBiase comes up, and we talked about this just a minute ago. Basically. Backstabbing Cody and DiBiase backstabbing each other.
You gotta say what it ends with, because it ends with what set up the match. He said Randy Orton said he didn't want either one of those guys to come out and help him tonight. You know, stay out of his face, stay out of his business, and yeah, they didn't.
That led us into Sheamus versus Randy Orton for the WWE title.
I hate Sheamus.
What's that?
I hate Sheamus.
I don't like him either, bro. I mean, that look is just not doing it, you know?
That's not a main eventer, bro. That's not a world champion. Get out of my face with that.
You know what? They're gonna continue to put him down your throat.
If that son of a bitch headlines WrestleMania wearing that title, I swear to God, man.
I'm telling you, man. It's gonna be...
I'm boycotting.
I don't think he walks out, but it's... I'm telling you.
He certainly doesn't walk out.
You know
he shouldn't walk in.
You know what? We can confirm that. I mean, that match is confirmed. It's gonna be Triple H versus Sheamus. Triple H versus...
I thought they were going with Shawn Michaels versus Triple H.
No, Shawn's Taker. It'll be Shawn.
Oh, they're going to do that still, okay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Without it, I mean, they're doing that storyline. They're still doing it on Monday Night Raw where Shawn's pissed off. All he wants is Taker.
Yeah,
I think
he's got his boo-boo face on.
Right. I think the eventual storyline in Taker eventually gets pissed off and says, you know what, fuck it, man. Let's do that. That's something like that. You know what I mean? Something along those lines. I don't know. So we'll have Triple H versus Sheamus. Come on, bro. WrestleMania, Sheamus I guarantee you, dude, if Sheamus walks into WrestleMania WWE champion, my man does not walk out of that pay-per-view as WWE, especially in a match with Triple H at WrestleMania.
He shouldn't walk in with a title either. You're going to bill one of your main title matches with this guy. Nobody knows the fuck Sheamus wants, man.
You've got to build somebody, right? And I understand, but look at his look. I mean, the guy's got the look. I mean, he's got the accent, which throws it off, and he's got the...
The accent ruins everything. I'm not racist.
Pale.
I'm not prejudiced.
I know.
I'm telling you right now, I don't know what the fuck he's talking about half the time. He's trying to sound like a threatening, big, terrifying guy, and he does not sound threatening with that accent. Maybe I'm being racist in that regard, but
you've got
I'm going to come down there and bullywalk your ass, you know. I'm not scared of that, you know.
But I don't know. He's got the look, man, and he's good in the ring. I mean, for a guy...
Is he? I don't pay attention to that.
Yeah, he's decent, man. I mean, he's got... Not that green, you know what I mean?
Imagine Triple H going into WrestleMania. He gets to go in and work with his buddy, his workout partner, and all that, and gets the headline show. Give him the WrestleMania main event payoff and all that. Here you go, buddy. Thanks for working out.
Not only that. Well, no, he'll stay in the title match. I mean, he's right there with Triple H. I mean, it pays to have friends in high places. You know what I mean?
The motherfucker's got the title already. What are we talking about here?
No, it's crazy, and they're shoving them down your face or your throat every week. You know what I mean? So I don't know, dude. I don't know, but it's just. I mean, Sheamus walked in WWE champion. Come on, he's in a match against Triple H. There's no way that Triple H doesn't walk out of
No, absolutely not.
And
he shouldn't. He should. Triple H should walk out with the title.
No, and when's the last time? I mean, you got to give it up for Triple H. I mean, when's the last time? I know he's got the DX thing going on right now.
Exactly. Don't give it up to him just yet.
Well,
if he was a singles guy, there would not have been this long of a streak without him.
Without a doubt. You are exactly right, dude. Speaking to
He's a unified tag champion right now. You know, he's got two belts. He's got two belts to carry around instead of one.
Right, they've got to do the DX split fairly soon too as well, and I think they're. I mean the storyline in recent weeks where Triple H is like, dude, chill out. You know what I mean? This is not a.
Yeah, he'll eventually get pissed off with him, and he can't turn heel. Shawn that would.
Yeah, that's right.
I can't even think how they would do that.
Well, Shawn would have to turn heel at some point. Well, Shawn would get pissed off if Triple H says that it's not a big deal. You know.
Yeah, that's what's gonna happen, and then Taker's a face anyway, so. Because Triple H can't go in heel working against Sheamus as heel. That just wouldn't work.
No. You'd have Triple H. I mean, Triple H would probably take a kick from Shawn, and then Shawn would turn heel, and then you'd have Shawn versus Taker. Shawn is the heel. Taker is the face at WrestleMania, and then you'd have Triple H as the face. Sheamus is the heel at WrestleMania. So they could do that. I mean, that is the plan, to do Triple H versus Sheamus for the title at WrestleMania.
And I know you're in a rush, but I do have to bring this up. I have to. It's not important to anything either, but the unified tag title, why is there still two different sets of belts? Like, are they ever going to defend just the WWE tag titles and just the world? Because if not, why don't you get one freaking thing called, you know, the unified tag title and have one belt? Why carry two around every time?
Right.
If you're never going to split the belts back up and have two sets of tag champions, why are they carrying all those belts around? It doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't make any sense, but that's not my call to make.
There you go.
That's not my call to make either.
No, it's not. But I
did. we had Sheamus retained here, retained his title. The funny thing is the crowd here, and the Royal Rumble crowd was off, man. I mean, that crowd was dead throughout the night, and Raw last night was dead, and then Strikeforce, my man, in Miami, of all places, had like a Japan wrestling crowd.
You said that. I don't remember paying attention to the crowd, but I do remember they were loud as shit when Rex Ryan.
Yeah, dude.
When he did the thing, they were loud for him.
You know, I was watching SportsCenter right before we came on here, where the NFL doesn't, I mean, they have this policy, I mean, no
game. Talking about the fine?
No game. Yeah, you got 50,000, bro.
Oh, that's it? Because they were talking on Howard Stern, that's how I heard about it, on Howard Stern yesterday. He said he flipped them off or whatever, and I guess he has a history of flipping people off in the NFL, and he's been fined before.
Well, no, they had the Bills owner, who's not a head coach, the owner has, I mean... NFL makes the owners live up to, I mean,
certain standards.
Put it this way. The Bills owner, when he flipped the people in the stadium off, or whoever he flipped off, I think his fine was like $250,000.
That's what it was, because that's what they were talking about on Stern, saying he was going to get fined $250,000 for flipping people off, and he wasn't even at an NFL game, and he was, you know.
Right, and basically just at an MMA event, he flipped the people off, but they fined him, I mean, he's the head coach, he's not an owner, but they fined him $50,000 earlier today for flipping somebody off. Jesus, man.
He wasn't even, the NFL's fining, like, that'd be like WWE, yeah, I guess it makes sense. I mean, if, like, Triple H did something bad at, like, a Strikeforce show and it made the news, WWE would do something. But, yeah, it just seems hypocritical to me that, you know, he's not even, the NFL season's over for him. He's still got to, like, be a good boy on other shows because...
Yeah, I guess you represent the team, you know what I mean? And I don't know, man. I mean, for flipping somebody off, Jesus, man. I mean, I'd love to come straight up to you and flip you off, but if I was...
The Rumble, because you lose your pay-per-view payoff, and that's a big pay-per-view.
Exactly. So, I don't know. We'll talk... So we've
Edge won the Royal Rumble. It was down to Edge and Cena?
It was down to Edge and John Cena. No, it was down to all three of them, and then Edge came up from behind and threw them all out, right? It was Cena and Edge. And Edge came in... Shit, I don't even remember. It was...
I remember one of them got thrown out, and they were outside the ring bitching, and then the Hogan Flair Sid finish.
It was Cena, Edge, and Batista, and you had Cena and Batista... that were over by the ropes, and Edge got up and came up from behind and threw them both out.
I thought, okay, maybe I'm wrong, but here's what I thought. I thought it was the same as the old Hogan Flair Sid, where, okay, Cena throws Batista out, And Batista's on the outside yelling at Cena, who's inside the ring. And then while Cena's distracted with Batista, Edge came and threw Cena out. That's how I remember. I don't know. Maybe I'm just thinking shit. Either way, Edge won the Royal Rumble. That's the point that matters here.
Yeah, Edge won the Royal Rumble. It was 49 minutes for this year's Royal Rumble.
That's right.
The official time. 49 minutes, no doubt, no doubt.
Edge was number, what, 29? They tried to throw people off a little bit.
Yeah, Edge was 29. Batista was
30.
right. All right, guys, that was the Royal Rumble pay-per-view from last night. By the way, you in the chat room, or Legend Killer in the chat room, says you are right, so... Whatever. That's the
Well, I'm always right, so I'm not surprised by that news at all. And by the way, most of the time, the chat results are poll results.
Let me vote.
It won't make a difference in
give
the winner.
Give it a B.
All right. Well, that'll just help it.
I'll give it a B.
B. There it goes. All right. What grade would you give the Royal Rumble pay-per-view? We got results. Winning in the number one with 40. Oh, we got more people voting now. More people tuned in and didn't see the poll. Okay, well, as of right now, we've got number one is B with 42.86% of the votes. Number two is C with 33. Now they're just voting like crazy. Screw it.
Yeah.
B wins, then C, then A, then B. So most people thought it was a 40, B or a C.
40% for B, 23% for A, 34% for
C. Now it's changed again.
I don't know. Let's just fuck it.
Screw it, man. B wins. That's the point.
Get to WZROnline.com/chat. Once again, WZROnline.com/chat. Man, we have such a good turnout on a weekly basis. It's crazy, man. I was talking to a buddy that's here right now sitting in back of me before we went on the...
I got one of those too right now. Staring at me while I'm doing the show. It's fucking annoying.
Staring at you, right? I was talking to a buddy and... basically, I said, it's crazy, man, that every Tuesday night from 7 to 9 Eastern time, these people come, and they come to the live chat room, and they come, and it's crazy. It's the same people. It's like every Tuesday night, your favorite TV show is on at 7 o'clock, right? And you come, and you tune in, and...
The last show ends, and the news and the theme for the first show, there they are. Never fails.
WZROnline.com/chat. Once again, WZROnline.com/chat. Get in there. We'll do chat shout outs here in just a little bit. For you new people, we're here every Tuesday night, 7 to 9 Eastern Time. WZROnline.com is the official home of WZR Radio. I want to talk a little bit about the fight in hour number two when we come back, too. So,
we got 9 minutes for the break. Do you think you can do it?
Here we go. Monday Night Raw from last
night. Can't be done.
9 minutes.
Cannot be done. I'm telling you.
It'll be done, my man.
William Shatner stuff, Bret Hart stuff, can't be done. Go for it. Let's see it. Let's see what you do. Edge promo, come on, man.
Yeah, we had,
Edge opens up the show.
I'm just trying to pick and choose here so I can get through. I guess this is taking up time right now. All right, Edge opened the show, came out and said that basically he won the Royal Rumble, and he gets a shot.
Crowd was dead for Edge, too, by the way, which I was pissed at because he was doing so good and the crowd was not into it at all. I couldn't believe it.
Right. This was it was a good promo by Edge.
It was great.
I was kind of nervous, man. I don't know. There was something about him. The guy hasn't been there for 6, 7, 8 months.
Yeah, but plus he's got the L factor where is he a heel or a face? Not is it WWE making him a heel or a face. It's how's the crowd going to react to him? Obviously, they're going to think he's a face if he's first coming back and everything, but yeah.
Right. We, Sheamus came out here. Help me out with this opening segment, and then I'm going to run down the matches.
Christ, bro.
Come on.
I mean, I don't even remember what they were arguing about, honestly, but I remember that Sheamus hit him with the microphone in the face, and then went to attack him some more. Edge got the spear.
Sheamus says he's going to walk out. I mean, basically, they announced the Elimination Chamber was returning at the pay-per-view. Sheamus says he's already entered into the Elimination Chamber, obviously, because he's the WWE champion. He says he's walking out of the Elimination Chamber as champion. Tells Edge to leave before he puts him back on the shelf. Puts him out for another month or whatever.
Because Edge said he could take Undertaker's title or this new guy who's never been in WrestleMania before, and he started to lean like, obviously, he's going to go with Sheamus, but then, Sheamus went and attacked him.
They Edge didn't leave, got in his face. Sheamus attacked, and Edge fought him off and retreated to the back. That was our opening segment. Then we had Elimination Chamber qualifying matches throughout the night. The first one was John Cena defeated Cody Rhodes by an attitude adjustment. This was a good match. All the qualifying matches were pretty good.
Yeah.
We had some backstage stuff with Vince McMahon. He says he doesn't think Bret Hart's going to show up tonight. He runs into William Shatner. in the locker room, which was good interaction. You know, I watch William Shatner. He's always on Conan when they do, I don't know. He does
year 2000?
In the year 2000. And
I love that shit. Do the voice, man. Can you do it?
In the year 2000! See, that's good, dude.
Yeah,
that's,
buddy.
I'll tell you what, man. You ain't hit puberty yet? Is that
no, not yet. No.
You ain't,
I'm still waiting, man.
What are you, 25, 26? You ain't hit
26,
puberty?
Yeah. It'll hit the match.
My man can still get his voice up like that, huh? Good for you, dude. Good for you.
Yeah.
Our next qualifying match, we had Triple H defeated Jack Swagger. This was decent, too, man. You said something about Swagger earlier.
No, that was just Jerry Lawler. When he first came out, you didn't know who his opponent was going to be, and Swagger looked real mean in the face, and Lawler was like, wow, no matter who is coming out, I'm pretty sure my money's going with Jack Swagger, and then time to play the game comes on.
It was a pedigree. Triple H wins by pedigree. We had William Shatner. This was weird where...
stupid.
He did the entrance.
They would play the theme music, and then he would read the lyrics for the theme songs off, and the way he acts, you know, he's like... A long time ago, in a dark and stormy, stormy closet, I came in. And so he was doing the typical William Shatner acting over the lyrics, which was pre-taped and stupid.
Stupid. We had a backstage segment. HBK is sad.
You like that?
Yeah, he was sad. Triple H tried to do his pep talk and basically said, "Chill out, man."
Because he even came in and he was joking, like, "Hey, I'm." Kick your ass for throwing me out the Rumble. He's like, I'm just doing it. You know, I would have done the same thing. You know, and he still couldn't get him, you know.
Randy Orton defeated Shawn Michaels. This is Raw match of the night, without a doubt. Orton, Michaels, same.
Another qualifier, by the way.
Yeah, when they announced that match, I mean, you've got Randy Orton versus Shawn Michaels in there. It doesn't get much better than that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
As far as, unless you got Chris Jericho versus Shawn Michaels or something like that. You had a backstage segment. Yeah.
Hold on. That was a chamber qualifier, and Orton won. I forgot those two parts.
Orton won by a via roll up. So right now you've got Randy Orton, Triple H, John Cena, and Sheamus as well in the elimination chamber. We had a another qualifying match. It was DiBiase defeated Mark Henry with a DDT. So now we've got DiBiase added. We had a backstage segment. It was Maryse talking with Gail Kim and Kelly Kelly. This is interesting, and I haven't found out why yet, but they were supposed to do a Divas match on Raw last night. Divas title match. It was supposed to be the end of that tournament that they've been doing in recent weeks. So Maryse against Gail Kim, and they never did that last night. And I don't know why just yet.
Maybe they'll save the title tournament final for the pay-per-view. Who knows? I don't know.
Well, the pay-per-view's a couple of weeks, so they...
True.
Yeah, we had Miz, Big Show, William Shatner, CM Punk, and his group walked in, and
they were arguing over who they wanted a unified title shot next week against DX. Both tag teams did. CM Punk and his group, and then Big Show and Miz, and they all argued. And Shatner did the Raw match negotiator, the Priceline commercial parody.
That's right.
And basically, in the end, after all the very bad comedy, we found out that DX would defend the unified titles in a triple threat tag match next week against CM Punk and Luke Gallows, as well as The Miz and The Big Show.
We've got a another backstage segment where HBK is still sad.
Yes.
Triple H tries another pep talk, same shit that we saw earlier, and doesn't work. Shawn Michaels turns his back if something walks out. Then we had Kofi Kingston defeated The Big Show. That was interesting, man. I mean, you could tell Triple H versus Swagger. You know Triple H is going over. DiBiase, you knew he was going in. But Big Show, you know, Kofi Kingston over Big Show? I mean, I was thinking for Elimination Chamber, you'd throw the Big Show in there. But nonetheless, we had, this is where Joe hit the ref, punched out the ref, and then basically complained, I didn't mean it, So he got screwed out of the
Kingston
chamber.
Got a finger in his eye, and he couldn't see, and he turned the punch, hit the ref, and then the other, he personally called for another ref to come down, and then the ref came down and disqualified him, and then he was shocked that he got disqualified. It was just weird.
Now,
why would you call another ref down, you know?
We're doing good here, my man. 3 minutes, huh? 3 minutes to go.
I'm shocked.
Now, I'm going to let you, I know you want to talk about this a little bit, and I'll comment when you're done, and then we'll go to the break. But we had the Raw ending last night. It was Vince McMahon and Bret Hart. Bret Hart came out first, and let's take it from there. And
you could probably do better than me, but yeah, he came out, and Christ, what did he bitched more about how he came back to make peace, and it was a hard decision to make after 12 years of, you know, not being there.
Right.
Comes
right.
in to make peace, and Vince, you know, won't have it, and he's pissed off, blah, 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 blah. Vince comes down. Like, if you remember what they talk about, you should do it, because I don't remember what... I just remember
Vince talked a lot of trash.
Vince
said something like, you know, a couple weeks ago, I had said I was going to induct your father into the Hall of Fame.
That's all.
And he says, I'm not going to do that anymore. And then Brett went off on him and said, you know, you couldn't lace my father's jockstrap, da-da-da-da-da.
Yes.
And Brett said...
Well, Vince also went on a... I remember some of the Vince stuff. I don't remember the Brett stuff for some reason. But Vince was, like, telling him he had no charisma, and he said the only reason he got over was because he put him in matches with... characters like Stone Cold and Mr. Perfect and Shawn Michaels.
They did a thing where a couple weeks ago Vince, you know, basically did an analogy where he said that Brett was a piece of gum, and Brett said, you know,
but he said that it's a piece of gum that lost its flavor, and when they lose the flavor, he spits them out. Meaning when wrestlers aren't no good no more, he just gets rid of them.
And
so,
then Brett said that this piece of gum had enough flavor left to kick Vince's ass.
Yeah,
right
just
now.
Enough flavor to kick his ass right now, and then he took his jacket. Yeah, so he did. He knocked him down. He threw some really goofy-ass punches that looked terrible, which surprised me. But he set up the sharpshooter, and you know, I was surprised he was going to do anything physical, and he was doing the sharpshooter, and for some reason Batista comes out and makes the save, which, like, I know they're starting an angle. I just don't know what, you know, they should have set up something to where we would have expected Batista to make, you know, because I'm just sitting there like, he's not on Raw, he's not in this story. What the hell is he doing?
Here's the thing. Nobody, okay, Batista came out and attacked Brett, and then he had the beatdown after Raw went off the air. Now you're thinking to yourself, all right, what are they going to do next? Somebody's got to help out Bret Hart. Who's going to be the guy to help Brett? And they're going to do this Batista versus Cena match. And maybe, like we said earlier, maybe it's a tag team match. Maybe they do the tag team match. It seems to me, and this is just, I don't have this confirmed or anything like that, but it seems to me that we're going to see a tag team match at the Elimination Chamber. It's going to feature Batista and Vince McMahon on one side against John Cena and Bret Hart on the other side. Then at WrestleMania, you break that tag team match down into singles matches.
Yeah.
You have Batista versus Cena and Bret versus Vince in a street fight, because that's obviously your bigger draw. It's two one-on-one matches. You know what I mean? That's your bigger draw for WrestleMania.
Still, I don't think they should put Brett in anything before WrestleMania. But let me get one caller in there, because this is just confusing me. It's a local number, so I want to see who the hell this is. Caller, you're on the air. Caller. No caller? Last chance.
Hello?
All right, get out of here. Yeah, right at the end, they say hello.
Right at the end, right?
It was a 904 number. That's my area code. So I'm like, who the hell's calling from here?
Yeah,
I don't know.
No doubt. Hey, guys, we've got a ton of people in the chat. Cue me some music up, boom. We'll finish up Monday Night Raw when we get back from the break. We're pretty much done with that, though. We're going to launch another live show during the break, and when we come back, and we're going to talk news, rumors, Strikeforce, UFC 109 this Saturday night on pay-per-view. Strikeforce from this past Saturday night on pay-per-view. Got a lot to talk about in hour number two. Chat, shout-outs, get some live chat right at WZRonline.com. You're listening to WZR Radio with Matt Boone and Ryan Clark. We'll be back right after this. Yeah, dude, it was, that was a brutal, brutal KO punch.
Yes,
it was. Round one, man, round one. And like you said, Lawler was on the losing end of that as well. So, I mean, Lawler was about to lose that fight, like you said. So,
yeah, and by the way, for those keeping tracking of our illegal gambling, I was up one coming into the show. Lashley, you had Lashley, so you got that one.
Right.
And then you had Lawler, so you had that one. So by this point, I'm thinking, oh, crap, what did I do? I'm about to lose a lot of money, because I didn't have, like, surefire. I had Herschel Walker. We wouldn't bet on Cyborg, because we both agreed Cyborg wins. And then I had Diaz in the main event. But
yeah. So you made it up at the end, man. But I was ahead. I mean, up until this point, I'm thinking, yeah, baby.
Yeah, you're going for big, because we bet big on that fight.
Going for the sweep, right? Going for the sweep, you son of a bitch.
And it didn't look very good at the beginning of the Herschel Walker fight. I mean, it quickly changed. But, yeah, either way, so Robbie Lawler wins that one by knockout, 333 of round one. After the fight, he couldn't walk. He was limping very bad all over the place.
Right.
They asked him if he'd be fighting Jake Shields, Dan Henderson winner. He was, you know, he gave the nice answer and didn't want to. He just said, I'll fight whoever they put in front of me. Herschel Walker was up next against, there was a big debate I ever had to say this guy's name. I think they stopped on Greg Nage or something like that they tried saying.
Yeah.
It looks like Nagy, so I'm just going to call him Nagy. Herschel Walker defeated Greg Nagy via TKO at 217 of the third and final round of that fight. And I don't know, man, everybody's talking, especially during the announcing on the event itself, about how impressive Herschel Walker looked. And I disagree big time.
Listen, here's the thing. I watched Sports Center. I watched it every day, morning, mm-hmm. nighttime, both editions, and they were all putting over Herschel Walker, and it was on the top 10, da-da-da-da-da. So was the Rex Ryan thing as well, da-da-da. It seemed to garner more press than the Herschel Walker fight did. But nonetheless, John Butchergross, who was on there, who I really like, he comes on at about noon, he said he wasn't impressed, and he was one of the only ones on SportsCenter that said that.
God bless him.
Here's the deal.
God bless that guy.
I watched the fight, and I had known that Herschel had been in training, and people said he looked like a beast. When that guy came out, and here's what you got to think, and me and you talked about this already. The dude is 47 years old. Look at him, bro. For a 47-year-old guy to walk out there, to go in, and to get a win in his first MMA fight ever, okay? How can you say that this guy, I'm not saying that he's a huge force to be reckoned with, but the guy is 47 years old, he is jacked up beyond belief, and he came out and did somebody in his first MMA fight. You've got to be impressed by that.
I'm not impressed by that. I'm telling you right now, maybe it's because they made it sound like I should be so impressed that I got to point out how not impressed I am, because they're making it sound like he's this new beast that they got, and the, oh shit, look out for Herschel Walker. You put him in with anybody, and dude, that'd be like, bro, it sounds nice he wins his first MMA fight. That doesn't mean anything if the guy he's fighting isn't an MMA fighter, and he was not fighting an MMA fighter. That guy was clueless.
Dude, he had the highest mouth
I've ever seen. He was sitting on his face, basically, and the guy couldn't buck him off. You're a retard if you don't know how to do that. You shouldn't be allowed to fight. He didn't know what he was doing. If you watch the technical aspect.
He won the fucking fight, dude. He won the fight against, I don't care if he's a jobber or not, the guy's been in some MMA fights.
No, he hasn't. You can't pluralize that. He's been in one MMA fight.
All right.
Okay. It'd be like putting you in the cage with a professional football player. Are you going to win the fight?
Come on, dude. Give him a chance. The guy's 47.
Hey, listen, I'll say this. I was impressed as hell with his cardio. Dude's 47. He went three rounds nonstop, and he was not breathing hard at all in the fight. I was shocked. But they talked about him being this Taekwondo god before the fight, and he couldn't kick for shit. I was watching. The guy's kicks suck. He couldn't break wind with those kicks.
Come on, I'm on the Herschel. You know what? I'm on the Herschel Walker bandwagon.
Well, I hope you're going to get knocked out just like Herschel does if they put him against anybody real, because that guy does not know how to. He learned one technique on how to defend a takedown. He did it the same way. He didn't know what to do once he defended it. He didn't know what to do when he got him. He had the guy mounted. He couldn't do anything. He was sloppy as hell.
I'm on the bandwagon.
Was it impressive that he won? Yes. Was it impressive that his cardio was up and great? Yes. Did he look like an impressive fighter that is going to be a good fighter the way they were talking about? Not even close,
man. His first fight, man. Come on.
I'm aware of that. But he looked like trash. He's 47. You don't have that much time to learn everything. He doesn't know anything. If you don't know something at least a little bit, you can't get it much better. You don't have much time to work with. He knows nothing.
All right, well.
Herschel Walker wins. Then from there, because I know you don't want to spend too much on MMA, because our fans hate it based on this poll right here.
we're gonna go back to, we've got WrestleMania 26, big WrestleMania 26 spoilers coming up. We're going to do that next, and then we'll probably end this show with some UFC 109 talk for this Saturday night on pay-per-view, Vitor vs. Coleman. So,
yes.
And on that.
So from there, the Herschel Walker, who we both agree was not impressive, right? We went to Cyborg Santa. You ain't gonna say nothing?
What's that? Herschel Walker.
I said.
I wasn't listening to you, but I caught it. Yeah. I'm on the bandwagon, but I don't know.
You're both getting knocked out in the next fight. Chris Cyborg Santos defeated, caller's gonna black it out for me here. Hold on. Marlos Conan via TKO from punches at 340 of round three. And I'll say this much for Conan, not O'Brien.
I know.
But she looked good, man. I mean, she was not afraid to stand with Cyborg. She was landing straight. You know, she looked impressive. Herschel Walker didn't. She was landing straight. She was doing good.
Right.
Cyborg would overwhelm her from time to time, but on the ground, she was staying busy because she's a jiu-jitsu fighter. She was looking for stuff. She couldn't find much because Cyborg's just a beast, so there's not a whole lot you can do with her. But, yeah, she lasted very long, longer than I expected. And in the end, it wasn't like she got eaten up and spit out. I mean, Gina Carano didn't make it one round with Cyborg. She made it almost four.
I know.
So you got to give her that.
Cyborg looked good, though. I mean, Cyborg.
You mean as a fighter, right? She doesn't look good, attractive.
Yeah. She's not terribly ugly. I mean, she is.
She's China, bro. She's China when China first.
She's not China. She's not as bad.
She's China.
She ain't as bad as.
I have nightmares about that woman. That thing. That whatever she is.
She's
I hope she's not listening, because she'll kill me.
You'd hit it.
I would hit it and run, because she'd hit me back, and it would hurt. But,
well, that's good. I like that. Right on the flag, baby.
From there, Cyborg 1 retained the title. They're maybe doing Cyborg Aaron Tohill next, or maybe another rematch with Gina Carano. I don't know, but we'll see. From there, we went to the main event. This was for the, I believe, welterweight title of Strikeforce. Nick Diaz versus Mario Zaremski. And Zaremski's was I mean, you didn't know going in, but it was like a very even fight on paper. As a matter of fact, I think Zaremski's was the favorite. And it didn't show in the fight at all. Diaz just gobbled him up and spit him out like he was nobody.
Yeah.
Which, you know, that's what he does sometimes. I mean, Diaz has a way of making guys look like they don't even belong in there. And that was a good fighter he was fighting. But, yeah, Diaz just completely – I mean, he stood with him the whole time, too. That was the other thing. Because the guy he's fighting, his last three fights he won not only by knockout, but he won all three of those fights by head kick. And if you know anything about MMA, it's not easy knocking somebody out with a fucking kick standing up. I mean, it's hard to do.
Oh, Jesus.
And, I mean, he didn't just knock you
– I don't think I could get my leg up to somebody's stomach. You know,
I didn't think I could until I have this recliner, this leather recliner. Remember I had the punching bag in New York, and I left it there like a dickhead?
Right.
So I don't have a punching bag, and I like to work out, and I got nothing to hit. So I seen this big leather recliner I sit in. It's got a real cushiony top part. It's about even with my midsection, maybe around my nipples, somewhere in there.
Since when does Matt Boone love to work out?
You didn't know that? I've always done a little boxing combination.
How many times have you seen me
in a room throwing punches at the air and shit? I do that shit for all the time. Everybody's like, what are you doing? But yeah,
getting prepared for my arrival down there at some point, right?
Yeah, I need a lot of preparation for that. But I kicked the chair, and I didn't think my whole point was I didn't think I could kick either. It was one thing I didn't. I can knee really good. I'm really quick on my feet. I can move around good, but I couldn't kick for anything. And I had this chair, and I'm kicking the chair. And now I think kicking's the best thing I do now. I didn't know I could kick that good, but yeah, that's my kicking story.
Yeah,
Nick Diaz kicked Mauro Zaremski's ass. 4:38 of round one, got the TKO, pretty much a knockout. And, yeah, I mean, he looked very impressive. New champion,
yeah,
Diaz.
The Diaz fight, I mean, I've always been a fan of both Diaz's, and he dominated, man, first round, right?
First round. What do you think now of maybe, and this, I don't think this is the plan, but what do you think of a Nick Diaz ruthless Robbie Lawler rematch from the UFC days?
I'll tell you what, I didn't even think about that, but I heard that Haran, because he beat Riggs, I was thinking, and then Diaz came out, and I think he said he wanted GSP, who's obviously over in UFC, and that didn't make much sense to me. Basically says that he would jump ship to go face Diaz. Did you read that?
Yeah, I saw the headline. I didn't read the article, but I mean, Diaz says shit all the time. Who knows? He's under contract.
Right.
He can't go to the UFC, but and GSP would kill Nick Diaz, so what are we talking about?
You can't.
I mean, first of all, Nick Diaz probably could outstrike him, but there's no way he could stop GSP from taking him down.
Right.
But again, Diaz is awesome on the ground. People forget that because he's so good at his stand-up lately, but
yeah,
Diaz primarily is a jiu-jitsu fighter.
Oh, he's got great striking. I mean, you can clearly see that in the fight on Saturday night. I mean, his strikes were right there. I mean, jabs, whatever. I mean, everything landed, you know.
Punches. Yeah, I mean, he doesn't hit hard. He pitter-patters, but when he wants to turn the power on, he can, which is that's how he catches people. They think they can eat the punches and walk through them, and then here comes a solid punch. Oh, shit. You know.
Right.
But,
that was
Strikeforce. We got the chat poll real quick. People are still voting, but I'll give you a basic scenario. People hate MMA that listen to this show. Did you watch Strikeforce on Saturday? 70. It's going to change now. Fucking asshole. Let me stop it. Hold on. I forgot.
I got 79%.
There we go. I just stopped it. Yeah, 78.62% said no. 21.38% said yes, which equates to 125 people said no. 34 said yes.
Ouch, man. Ouch. Jeez. People voting in the poll tonight, huh, man? I like this new poll idea, my man.
We were forced to find it out because the fucking Justin TV sucks. Yeah.
Yeah,
if you're listening, Justin, you're a piece. I'll kick you.
last week.
They changed the site up.
And I was fucking crazy. I don't know what the deal is. And then tonight, dude, we had a problem tonight, too. Hopefully next week we'll be able to get on here. Guys, we've got our live chat. We're going to get back into wrestling right now. We've got WrestleMania 26 spoilers coming up right now. We're going to run down the current rumored card right now. And then we've got to talk. And we had the passing of Jack Briscoe, who we need to talk about. And We've got the Helms Jericho incident, and we want to take live phone calls as well. So we're going to get to all of that here in just a little bit. So, WZROnline.com/chat. Once again, WZROnline.com/chat.
When do you want to do callers? Are we working them in whenever, or are we going to save a segment at the end, or...
Wow, what was I just going to do? I forgot what I was just going to do.
I have no idea.
Well, we're going to move on to the news and rumors. Yeah, WrestleMania. That's what it was. WrestleMania 26. All right, guys. We talked about it earlier in the show, but for those of you who tuned in late, we'll give you a quick rundown of what is scheduled. I can't stress this enough. This is rumored. These are the top rumored matches for WrestleMania.
And how we were talking about how WWE changes plans at the last minute for Raw and stuff every week.
Exactly.
When it comes to WrestleMania, big time changes. Come on, man.
Even, I mean, 10 times worse than your normal weekly Raw.
Exactly. So these are definitely rumors, right? But it's being talked about.
Just because Ryan Clark or Matt Boone says it doesn't mean it's confirmed. I can't stress that enough. I know this will wind up on forums tomorrow. This is, this is confirmed, blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
Rumored. So here we go. We've got The Undertaker versus Shawn Michaels. They have obviously started this storyline weeks back. They're continuing it on Raw where Shawn is disappointed. I mean, this means everything to him. He wants a main event of WrestleMania against The Undertaker. That match is tentatively scheduled for WrestleMania. So The Undertaker versus Shawn Michaels. We talked about Triple H versus Sheamus earlier.
Could you tentatively?
Title. Right?
Good.
Sheamus going to walk into WrestleMania as WWE champion. You got Triple H versus Sheamus for the WWE title there. It's WrestleMania. It's Triple H, main event, WWE title on the line.
That sounds good so far. Now, who's he facing again? What was that?
Sheamus.
Okay, I'm not watching. Never mind.
We've got, this was scheduled, and we talked about this throughout the show, but we've got John Cena versus Batista. This is supposed to be the interbrand match, the big interbrand match for this year, Cena versus Batista. Obviously, you've got a wrench thrown into the plans with Bret Hart and Vince McMahon as well. So basically, they could do a tag team match. This could turn into John Cena and Bret Hart against Batista and Vince McMahon. They could do that, or it could be singles matches where you'd have John Cena against Batista and a gimmick match, probably a street fight of some sorts between Vince McMahon and Bret Hart at WrestleMania.
Wow, you know what I didn't even realize, man?
What's that?
I'm sorry to interrupt, but we mentioned the Raw rating earlier, 3.6, and we didn't even say anything. Like, Bret Hart was advertised for a week.
I don't think
fans today give a shit about Bret Hart. That should be the next poll.
And they don't. That's great. I mean, back in the day, you know what I mean? Bret Hart would be a huge, huge draw. And we never talk about TNA on Thursday nights, but I'll tell you what, I watched Impact this past Thursday night, and Eric Bischoff, I mean, you've got to give the guy props. I mean, the stuff that he did backstage, and then there were segments that, God, Boone, if you could, I mean, you're a Flair mark, man. If you could view these things, they had backstage.
I watched.
Dude,
I was ready to make pullout. I've been watching Impact every week, man, yeah.
I'll tell you what, man, Impact is on Thursday night.
I'm all about it.
We never talk about Impact, you know what I mean? But they drew a 1.4, which is an all-time record last Thursday.
On Thursday,
which is an all-time record. I mean, Eric Bischoff, some of his stuff that he did backstage where he had Bobby Lashley back there and he said, you're fired, get out of my... some of the stuff, they had a segment not too long ago, it may have been on the pay-per-view, but they had Abyss back there with Eric Bischoff and Hogan.
That was Impact.
They had Hogan and Foley in some segments as well. I mean, Impact on a weekly basis. If you're not a TNA fan, check it out on Thursday night, because that show, I mean, I know a lot of old men, a lot of people are pissed that they're bringing in. Even they did a thing last week with the Nasty Boys and Team 3D where they went back and forth on the mic. And I know it's the Nasty Boys, and nobody wants to see the fucking Nasty Boys, obviously. But
was that good?
The segment that they did on Impact was so well done. It came across awesome on TV last week.
What I do is I don't watch Impact on TV. I download it, but every week since the Hogan stuff, I've downloaded every show, watched it, and skipped around, you know. And I saw the Nasty Boys Dudley stuff, and I skipped it because I thought it would suck. I guess I should have watched it.
No, go back and watch that, man. They went back and forth on the mic, basically just tearing each other up, and that was really well done last. I mean, Impact last week as a whole, I was really impressed with that
Me
show.
Too, man.
And, you know, they're bringing in these older guys and doing stuff. You know what I mean? It's working, man. It's working.
I like it. I don't like watching much wrestling nowadays because it sucks so bad. But I'm all about Impact right now. I'm all about it.
It's so easy to shit all over TNA because they're bringing all these different guys in.
Hey,
the fact is some of the storylines have been great over on.
Yeah,
TNA,
they have. No, it's a different TNA than you've ever been seen before. That's for sure.
Right.
What was I going to say? Oh, did you hear the Bubba thing I sent you yet? The state of the TNA address.
No, dude, I still have to go back.
Oh, you gotta listen to that. That is the greatest.
I heard Bischoff was cussing like a mother.
Yeah. Well, it was a serious XM show, so they were allowed to cuss. And I think
why
Bischoff
didn't you? We should have aired that tonight, dude. For the
I didn't even think about it. I didn't even cross.
Why don't we do that next week? If you guys guess it, because a lot of people don't get to hear that.
I still got it.
Yeah, let's do. Well, I got it. I could send
okay.
it. But nonetheless, we have the next. I'll tell you what. Next week, we do a, for those of you guys that come here at 7 o'clock Eastern Time.
A lot of them do that, too.
A lot of them, yeah, tons of them come right at 7 o'clock, right when we go in the air. Usually we play music for the first hour. We go live at 6 o'clock.
Eastern.
And then from 6 o'clock Eastern. And then from 6 to 7 o'clock Eastern Time, we've got music. But I'll tell you what, next week, we'll play the State of TNA address.
It's exactly an hour, too, so it'll fit perfect. And I'm telling you right now, man. We've done, I dare I say, thousands of hours of WZR in our history.
Right.
I'm going to say, and I'm a huge Howard Stern fan who's done millions of hours, dare I say, of radio. This was probably the greatest fucking hour of radio I've ever heard in my life. It was great, man. It
really?
Was awesome. Because it was wrestling, but it was like cool radio, too, at the same time. Because Bubba's the man. If you don't like him on TNA, you'll like him on the radio. Trust me.
All right, we'll do that. So get here. If you guys want to hear the State of TNA address from Bubba the Love Sponges show from, I think it was last week, maybe 2 weeks ago. Last week it was. We're going to air that next Tuesday night, all right? Next Tuesday night from 6 to 7 Eastern Time. And then at 7 o'clock, you'll hear our live theme, our opening theme. And then we'll go live and we'll be here for 2 hours. But next Tuesday night, be here at 6 o'clock Eastern Time if you want to hear the State of TNA address from several weeks ago. That's
you got to listen to that too tonight, man. That is a good. That's a great hour, man. Great hour. By the way, we were talking about Bret Hart, and I added a new poll. So if you guys listening to the stream want to vote on the poll, it should say poll on your stream on the bottom left. Just click that and vote. The question for the poll is: do you look forward to Bret Hart segments on WWE TV? And the options are yes and no. So we want to find out why the ratings are not budging for advertised returns of Bret Hart these weeks. You would think it would. I would have thought it would have been huge rating difference. Like he would have made a big difference. He's making no difference at all.
Yeah,
both times.
No difference. That's crazy. And one time you had TNA's audience, which didn't even leave. I mean, when they did the Monday Night
War, TNA was considered the winner of that. I mean, they didn't beat him in the numbers, but like for whose business increased with what they were doing more? WWE's went down, TNA's went way up. It's like,
right.
But WWE had Bret Hart after 12 years, the screw job. Why? You know, this week there was no excuse. There was no Monday Night Football. There was no TNA. Nothing.
Think about the fan base right now. I mean, it's a lot of younger fans.
That's what they're going for, too, yeah.
You know what I mean? I mean, exactly. I mean, with the
Well, that's why I put this poll up, because I'm trying to gauge if people just, either they don't know who Bret Hart is or they don't care. You know what I'm saying?
Well, from the basing on the early results here,
we're asking a bunch of marks, though. Don't forget.
Well, I know that's true. A lot of people,
of course,
a lot of people on the internet are you know what I mean. A lot of people on the internet are going to be fans of Bret.
If you're listening to this show right now, you're a mark, pretty much. Let's put it that way.
Right.
Yeah.
Hey, let's talk about news and rumors real quick, and then we're going to open the phone lines up here in just a minute. Next week's Raw guest host is NASCAR guy Carl Edwards. Jesus, man. They had Joey Logano and Kyle Busch, was it?
Kyle Busch.
Jesus Christ.
I don't know who any of these guys are. I've heard the name Kyle Busch. Other than that, I don't know who Joey is or Carl.
No,
I don't know.
I know Carl Edwards, but I mean,
okay, I don't.
Whatever. Whatever. And then we've got big match that Boone talked about earlier, DX versus CM Punk and Luke Gallows versus Big Show and The Miz. Here's something I want you to touch on because, you know, back in the 70s, you know me, I came in the early Attitude era, early 90s, mid-90s, and we had the passing of Jack Briscoe at the age of 68 the other day. You know, I remember the commercials back in the day where they did the Briscoe Brothers auto sales,
yeah,
things of that nature. I remember that stuff, but beyond that, you're going to have to run me through it.
Well, yeah, because they made Gerald Briscoe a character on WTV, so the people are familiar with Gerald probably more than Jack, but Jack was a star.
Somebody compared, like they said that, you know, you would take a Kurt Angle of today, and back in the 70s, Jack Briscoe was the Kurt Angle of now.
Well, okay, here's the thing. I can't give you a lot of personal stories because I just missed the Jack Briscoe era. I started watching wrestling like hardcore, nonstop, religiously in probably the mid to late 80s. And Jack was, I mean, he was still around, but he was more of a 70s, early 80s kind of guy. And then Ric Flair and Dusty Rhodes and all those guys started taking over when I started watching. But Jack Briscoe was a NCAA amateur wrestling champion, kind of like Brock Lesnar and Bobby Lashley and people like this. And so he was considered like the Kurt Angle, like you said. He was the real wrestler of the group. He was the legit guy that could whoop your ass, you know, even though he didn't look like it. And I should mention, because I'm a Native American, 75% 25% Italian, Jack Briscoe, full-blooded Native American. He was the first, and I believe to this day, the only, I'm not sure about that second part, but he was definitely the first Native American to ever win the NCAA championship. So that was like a big deal for him and his heritage. And then him and his brother, Gerald, who a lot of WWE fans would know from the Attitude Era, he was, you know, Gerald Briscoe and Pat Patterson, the Stooges. But, yeah, so Jack and Gerald Briscoe as a tag team won the NWA Tag Team Championships. I can't even count how many times. A lot of times. And they were like the tag team of the time. And then they split up. Jack Briscoe ended up winning the NWA heavyweight title back when it was clearly the title in wrestling, way more than WWE, you know, et cetera. And he won that twice. So, I mean, Jack Briscoe was a legit superstar of wrestling for a long period of time. And, yeah, that's a big loss for the wrestling community. Jack Briscoe, you'll be missed, man.
Yeah, that's, I mean, I didn't hear yeah, I didn't know much about him, but I know. I mean, I've just heard from people that it's just a huge,
that's a big name. Yeah, I tried to explain it to you. If you hear Ric Flair promos, anytime he says, when you mention your Ric Flairs and your Dusty Rhodes and your Funks, he's
right,
always got to say Briscoes too, because Jack Briscoe was the man. So.
Yeah, it's just crazy. I mean, 68. He had health problems in recent years as well, from what we put up on the websites. But at the age of 68, he passed away. Yesterday it was. So that was,
it was good that they got him in the WWE Hall of Fame.
Right.
We
didn't mention that last night on Monday Night Raw, before Raw went live, they aired a graphic of him, and they also did a video package in.
And the announcers talked him up too for a little spot there where they got. Yeah,
right.
So that was good. I was surprised they got all that together, and because the story broke that day.
Two more things, and then we're going to open it up to the phone calls. Bret Hart and Jeremy Borash went out after Monday Night Raw last night, had a meal. Jeremy Borash posted a photo of this on his Twitter account, which I have taken.
Where could you find it? I mean, if you wanted to go online and see this photo, I'm sure there's some place you could do it.
I've got this website, and basically it just it deals with TNA wrestling. We don't cover WWE or ROH or any of the
Tell
other,
me about this website, know, Ryan. Give me more information about this.
Yeah, basically we just cover TNA, the world of TNA wrestling, all the superstars of TNA wrestling. We cover pay-per-views on a weekly basis as well. And, you know, photos such as Bret Hart and Jeremy Borash out eating dinner after Monday Night Raw. We have a gallery section over there on TNA Wrestling News.
You don't say.
That we just launched, and you know, it's over at a little website we like to call TNAWrestlingNews.com.
.com. There it is.
TNAWrestlingNews.com. That's all you got? I thought you were going to be like,
you may not hear
it. Built it up good, dude. And then when I said TNA Wrestling News, kind of shit all over it.
My thing is saying .com. I echo your .com like Mr. Anderson. But, you don't hear it, but we're echoing every time we talk at the same time, so it's hard to cut you off when I went. So I just kind of let you go. Usually I can stop you dead in your tracks. See, like right there you would normally stop, and then you didn't hear me for a second. But anyway, TNAWrestlingNews.com is a great website. I visit it every day.
Live
what do you think of that?
Galleries.
Live? Baby live. What are we talking about?
Don't visit TNAWrestlingNews.com.
Of course not, but I'm trying to help you here, man.
Fuck out of here. guys on live radio blatantly lying to you guys doesn't fit my team. Get at it.
Right? You know, be honest. I think TNA sucks. I think your website's trash, and I'll never visit it, no matter what.
Come on.
It's a good web. It's the best TNA. I'll give you that. Like, my MMA site is one of the best. I won't say we're the best because we're not, but we're one of the best MMA. You're the best TNA website.
I'll tell you what. By the end of this week, I believe MMAnews.com may be one of the premier top-rated MMA websites on the internet today. Are you guys still watching that Thursday?
Yeah, right? Well, we already are one of the premier, by the way, as far as numbers are concerned. I mean, we're considered probably the third biggest MMA site online.
Coverage
stuff, yeah.
There's a website called ChairDog, and I mean, basically, that's the king of all MMA websites.
That's number one.
And I would say that MMAnews.com, what, this Thursday, Friday, over the weekend, next week sometime, it's going to give them a run for their money, my man. You know what I mean, dude?
I don't want to comment on the direct comparison to the site you mentioned for reasons pertaining to other work commitments.
Yeah,
I won't go there. But MMAnews.com is definitely coming and bringing the fucking noise next week. Yeah, that's happening. So check us out.
Yeah, check it out. No doubt. We're going to get back into UFC 109 as well here in just a few minutes. One more thing, Boone, and then we're going to open up the live phone lines. They called
for
about
15
minutes. Yeah, no doubt. Probably blasting us off.
Oh, yeah.
We've got to talk about this, bro. We had Chris Jericho and the Hurricane last week after the SmackDown tapings Tuesday night. I believe it was early Wednesday morning at about 5 a.m. They were arrested. TMZ.com broke the story. And basically what happened is everybody was in a cab. Matt Hardy was there as well.
Mm-hmm.
It seems to me like a case of guys going out. This is funny because when guys go, I mean, I'm basically going to compare Hurricane Helms to like the Matt Boone and my crew from back in the day where he's like the angry... Like
angry
the angry
drunk.
The angry drunk that, you know, and it never had, it was always the hard liquor that did it to you, it seemed like. It wasn't the, I mean.
I don't pay attention to that. I don't know.
The beers were cool, but I mean, some people just lose it. And basically, there was a, Chris Jericho had a tweet or something where he said they were having a Grey Goose vodka drinking contest the night before. Basically, you get to 5 o'clock in the morning, something happened in the cab, I don't know, maybe Helm was passed out and they were fucking with him and he woke up and he was drunk and he flipped out and punches were thrown. It's just a case of a couple of buddies going out, getting fucking plastered. You know what I mean? Punches are thrown and then you wake up the next day and you're thinking, what the fuck did I do last night? You know
we've
I mean?
Been there, have we not? Do you want to get into that
oh
one?
My God, dude, we've been there. Me and you have thrown punches at easy. I remember the time we were outside in the fucking, we were outside in the hallway, and I'm hauling off on you with punches, and all of them are missing, dude. Nothing's hitting.
You were hitting me on the top of the head, yeah, and I was like blowing kisses at you.
Yeah, true. And you wake up the next morning, and you're like, oh, Jesus, dude, what, you know.
Oh, you don't want to tell the part about what I did. You can say that you hit me in the head a million times. You can't tell them what I did? That doesn't want to be mentioned?
Jesus, the knee in the face where I got the bloody nose. Yeah,
I got our boy with a tie clinch, and then the pump clinch tossed the knee up and fucked the shit up, man.
Yeah, I'll tell you. Boone ain't shit. I'll tell you guys right now, Boone ain't shit. And if you fuck it right now, I'd do it again tonight.
But that was the same thing. Like, we woke up the next day, and we looked at each other like, what the fuck was that, man? Yeah. Well, I'm not bad, dude, you know?
How many times do you wake up? I mean, you wake up with bruises. I'd wake up with bruises. All over me. Just
remember when I first moved down there, my arm, what you did to my left arm, bro? Holy shit.
Oh, Jesus.
I had a bruise going from my shoulder to my wrist. I'm not exaggerating. It was a giant
I had to pinned up against the post or something, man.
You had me stuck between the bed and the wall, and you're just relentlessly pounding the shit out of my arm. We would do shit like UFC and stuff, you know. And
Right.
He would win a few of them.
We've had some wars there. Whatever. Guys, get to the live chat room, WZROnline.com/chat. That's the basic gist of the Hurricane Helms, Gregory Helms, Chris Jericho story. So, I mean, basically, that was the deal. Wake up the next morning and say, Jesus, man, what the hell happened? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Let's take live phone calls. We're going to open up the phone lines right now. We've only got one phone line, guys. So if you don't get through and somebody's on the line, if you hear us talking to somebody, there's no delay on this show. We got about a two-second delay, if that. So if somebody's on the line, lay off the calls for a few minutes. When we hang up, and then call in. 518-712-3070. 518-712-3070. Give us a call right now.
All right, caller, you're on the air. What's going on, buddy?
Legend Killer in the chat. Okay.
I've been sitting out throughout the whole show.
Great show as usual, guys. But two things. I was going to comment first on the Gregory Helms Jericho incident. You know, I can't remember. I read, I believe it was JBL said, let's look at it this way. They weren't doing drugs and they weren't driving. They were smart enough to get a cab. Who cares if they got a little drunk and hit a couple of people? Pay them off, you know, just and get on with it. And, the second thing was people have been sitting in the chat room talking about something about some news on cabs that they want y'all to talk about, and I ain't heard nothing about no news on cabs. Everybody's been screaming for it, so there you go, guys. I plugged it for you. Catch y'all back in the chat.
All right, thank you. The news about Taz is just, what, he needed surgery on his leg, and he's not going to miss any time from announcing with TNA, so that's not really news, I don't think.
No, there's a...
is there more than that?
Yeah, there's a story. We're not going to break it here. I'm going to put it up.
I didn't know we were advertising a Taz.
No, I'm going to break it.
Oh, it's Kaz, they said. Who the hell's
Kaz? Kaz. Frankie Kazarian. Suicide.
Oh, okay.
Well, I have a exclusive story that you know who I talked to.
Yeah.
And I have an exclusive, and I put up a thing on the website yesterday that says it's a pretty wild story. I haven't talked to you about this. Pretty wild story involving Kaz, and I'm going to break it. I've been breaking stories, exclusive stories on TNAWrestlingNews.com. And
we gotta get to somebody's call, man.
Yeah, I'm gonna put that up probably tomorrow, if not tomorrow. I just want to confirm something, and I'll get that up. But it's gonna be up on TNAWrestlingNews.com.
Sounds like a good one, man. It's a good site to check it out on. Caller, you're on the air. What's going on, brother or sister?
Hello.
Yeah, go ahead.
Hello. Hey, how's it going? I wanted. Do you think I ever bring back the television title?
Okay. What about it?
Hello.
Get out of here, dude.
What the fuck are you talking about, dude? Something about the TV title? Something about the television title?
There is no television title right now, is there, anywhere?
I thought he said he wanted to talk about the television title. Maybe he said something about a return. I don't know. The television title? I don't think so. Ring of Honor is going to introduce a TV title here in the coming weeks on HDNet. I don't know if that's what he's talking about. But as far as WWE or TNA, I don't believe so. I mean, there's no plans to do anything like that right now.
So there you go. Caller, you're on the air. What's going on, man?
Oh, you guys are too funny, man. I was laughing at the television dude. He did the blah, blah, the what, the blah. What'd you say? The television title. Oh, man, get out of here, man. You're not too funny. But a quick question, one wrestling, one MMA, per se. I've been reading different sites that they say TNA has too many wrestlers. And I remember when supposedly some said they wanted to release. If you had too many wrestlers, and people, let's say, like Homicide or whoever else, say, I want out, why don't they just say, okay, well, Bischoff and Hogan, maybe let them out since he got new people, or you think they'll try to beg them also if other wrestlers ask for their way out of TNA?
I mean, Ryan would know better than me, but I say it would be a case-by-case situation. I mean, it depends on who we're talking about, you know? I mean,
yeah, basically, I mean, you're going to have... Here's the deal, and let me load up an email. This is the guy that I talked to that got the suicide story as well that I'm going to break. But it says, don't know where things are going. Wait a minute. Scan through this. He says,
yeah, like
I said,
don't just read it, man.
He says, all storylines are being rewrote the day of the show lately, so we'll see what happens. So basically... Eric Bischoff, you had your Vince Russo storyline for months and months and months. He's the guy that was in charge. Eric Bischoff is coming in here. He's taking a completely new direction with the creative side of this company. And basically, once he gets a pattern in place where they take 3 weeks' worth of Impact last week, right? Once you get a couple months in and Eric Bischoff is fully in charge, those talents that aren't being used in top storylines are going to be on the bubble. But basically, right now, everything is changing original storyline plans because TNA has their stuff planned out for months in advance, and they always have. It's not like WWE. Well, I don't want to say that, but TNA had more of a... more of a plan over a few month period, and they always followed through with that plan, where WWE normally goes week to week. They've got a general idea, but not a whole, you know, a whole major storyline with everything that's going to go down like TNA does. So I would assume that once Bischoff's creative plans are in place and things get moving,
they'll clean house.
They'll clean house, and that'll happen, you know, in the next couple
of months. I was wondering
if
you were ever going to bounce back to his point, because that had nothing to do with anything, but
well,
we got there.
You wanted
to know that when the guys that asked for the releases and people like that, and if, you know, so, but yeah, you got there.
Yeah, since I said supposedly too many wrestlers, these are like internet people, I'm just saying. And the question, you know, I seen the Lashley fight, you know, to me, he's been fighting.
Wait, before you go to your question, man, Herschel Walker, was he impressive or was he not impressive?
Okay, I'll put it like this. He's okay, but he had to stand him up because he played football. You have to have that kind of endurance when you play football, running for, you know, quarter after quarter. So I think that's why he had, you know, all the cardio and everything, because he's used to that. But, you know...
Impressive cardio, everything else sucked.
He's okay, but if he was going to, like, the UFC kind of cast, UFC would do it. I have to agree, I'm sorry. I like you, Ron, but Mr. Boom's making sense. He'll get eaten up in UFC because
I never once said that if he went to UFC or if he stepped up and fought somebody that's a legit name, sure, he'd probably get a dance kick. But the fact is, he's not gonna step up right now. They're gonna feed him jobber after jobber after jobber. And once he gets a few belts under his belt, who's to say that this guy can't become a star?
I'm saying technically, is he impressive or not impressive? And I'm saying technically speaking, as a fighter, not impressive. The technical aspect of his fighting is not there. I mean, he got by on just being stronger than the guy, pretty much, and having good cardio.
He's a football player. Let's say T.O. 10 years from now, if MMA is still doing their thing and he wants to fight, he might. And if he fights the same way, they say, hey, that's T.O. They don't care. Get the interview. Oh, you know, he even had a couple of punches, but you know, I'm T.O. and you know, I'm glad I won the fight. You know, he'll add them stupid interviews like that, I think. I don't know. But,
pull a Sharpie out of his sock and sign somebody's... I love T.O., man. That guy's awesome. What was your question real quick, man? We got to move on.
Yeah, me too. You know, lastly, to me, you know, I think he's been fighting jobbers, I'm thinking. With what you've seen, the 4 or 5 fights he's won, when or if will Dana White pick up the phone and say, you know what, I need you in UFC, and let's say he goes... Let's say Dan White calls him today and say, you know, you're with us, and he goes there. How long do you think he can hang fighting the UFC kind of lightweight vets before, you know, in the heavyweight division, you think, if Dan White calls him to join UFC? And that's all you guys.
All right. Thanks, buddy. Bobby Lashley, I'm not insanely impressed with him either so far. But, I mean, you could say it's still early, but he's had, what, 5 fights now? You would be able to see some, like, progression of his skills, and he still fights the same way he did in his first fight.
I think if he fights Brett Rogers, I think we'll really see him step up and see what he's got.
Maybe because people think of Brett Rogers as like a good fighter now because he shocked Fedor, but that still doesn't mean he's good. We don't know what Brett Rogers is yet, but I say that fight Lashley could take him down like he does everybody else and maul him. So
right.
That doesn't change it. We got to see somebody who could match his wrestling and force him to show the other aspects: stand up, submissions, things like this.
Right.
And when we see that, we'll be able to gauge a little better what Lashley can do. But right now, will he go to UFC? No, I mean, he's just signed with Strikeforce, so he's going to be there for at least a few fights, and they're going to do whatever they can to keep him because that's a big deal, Lashley, to them. So, but is he ready for top guys in UFC right now? No, not even close.
Okay.
So that's that. And I guess we can take it easy on the calls. We only got 5 minutes left. We got UFC 109. Do we have anything besides UFC 109 to talk about?
Well, we can...
Any spoilers yet? Anything?
No, I'm looking at my email for spoilers right now. I believe the new name of ECW is going to be WWE Next, WWE NXT, I believe. I don't have that confirmed just yet. Spoilers should be out. I think they're on the in Central Time Zone, so
yeah.
We'll have to wait and see. But it looks like the NXT, WWE. It'll be WWE, the NXT stands for Next Generation, I believe. So WWE, Yes, it'll be standing for, I don't have this confirmed, but I believe they're going to drop the ECW letters and they're going to go under the name WWE NXT, with the NXT representing Next Generation. I don't have that confirmed, but I believe that's going to be the new name of ECW. And it's
so they're just spelling Next wrong? It's not like initials for something? Like New Extreme Wrestling?
WWE NXT, which is Next Generation, which would stand for WWE Next. WWE NXT. Can you imagine that? NXT. NXT.
I guess, man.
I don't know, dude. Whatever. Next Generation. So that is the new name of ECW. That should be announced tonight on the show. I don't know if St. Louis, I'm guessing St. Louis is in the central time zone, so maybe a 1 hour delay on that show. So I don't know. We'll have to wait and see what happens. All right,
let me do some chat shout outs.
Yes, chat shout-outs. Let's do it. We'll go from the
I'll start it off since you're getting in there. Well, I'll start from the top. We got my main man, Wayne D, in there, Lil Wayne. We got Amp. We got Boone's son. We've got Boone's spoon. We got Boone's wife, Tiffany. We got CJC, DJ Thriller. We've got Fedor Needs a Title Shot. We've got Ham and Egger. We've got Hurricane. We've got I Hate Hogan, James Rolls, JJ, Joe Bill, Juju B, Juggalo 420, Killjoy, King Elvis Presley, Lithium, Living Dead Guy, and LOLOLOLOL. Who else we got?
We've got Maka, Not Nice is in there, R-Dub, Rings of Saturn, Ron, 65101, Shaman of Sexy, 6 Foot Goods, Super KO, Swax, The Game, 909469, The One Man Dynasty is in there, The People's Champ, 21, The Crimson McFanny, The Hammer, TNA 12, Tommy Welshie, Wally 76er, and
Word.
There's your chat shout-outs. Ryan, WWE Champion, has joined WZRonline.com/chat as well.
Let me do this too real quick. We got the chat poll. We put up the third one. Do you look forward to Bret Hart's segments on WWE TV? Yes was the resounding answer, 79.68% or 149 votes. So that's what the consensus was. No was 20.32% or 38 votes. So a resounding yes, they look forward to Bret Hart segments.
Ryan, WWE Champion in the chat room says, fuck you, Ryan. Fuck you right back, my man.
There you go. Power of the microphone.
Power of the microphone.
You can't say nothing back.
And live radio, baby.
Because we are live. Oh, yeah.
That about does it. UFC
Saturday. Check it out. UFC 109, Randy Couture versus Mark Coleman. Good show. First time ever, Hall of Famer versus Hall of Famer. The undercard is stacked, so definitely check it out. It's going to be a good one. UFC 109 this Saturday. If you can't check it out, you can check out www.mmanews.com for live coverage, video interviews, all that good stuff. MMAnews.com.
Thanks to everybody who came out in the live chat room tonight, no doubt. As always, thanks to everybody who called in. We're going to be here next Tuesday night from 7 to 9 Eastern Time. Same time, same place this week. I'm looking for somebody to help us out with WZRonline.com, the website. If you know anybody good at design, shoot me an email at webmasterprowrestling.com and work out some details. A little bit of pay involved as well. Give me a shout, webmaster@prowrestlingsweeks.com. Matty Boone, it's been fun, my man.
Sounds good to me, man. We did another one.
We'll do another one, man. We'll see you next Tuesday night, 7 to 9 Eastern Time, guys. WZRonline.com for
Matt Boone. That's me.
This is Ryan Clark.
That's him.
And see you next Tuesday night, guys. Have a good week.
Boom! Oh!